Hello you guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to a really exciting vlog. So today is Sunday, it's actually Sunday evening now. I have just finished work, I've just got home and got changed, and we are now off on a really exciting trip. I mentioned in one of my Vlogmas videos that Matt and I have been off to do something secret. And the secret thing that we'd been doing was going to meet a litter of Sprolly puppies. So a Sprolly is half Springer Spaniel, half Border Collie. So it's like a sheepdog with spaniel ears. So if you watched Vlogmas Day 13, I was being incredibly cryptic about a secret thing that we were doing. That day is today. We have just been to see the puppy and it went really well. He is beautiful. I'm going to put some photos in over this, but he's really cute. He's got a really lovely temperament. We met his mum and she has a really lovely temperament too. She's really calm, really intelligent, very well trained. And we learned a bit about her ancestry line as well, which was really interesting. So it sounds like he comes from good stock. So so we're going to get him, which is really exciting. We put a deposit down on him on that day, and today he turned 8 weeks old, so we're gonna go pick him up and bring him home. I'm really excited. We took the Christmas decorations down the other day specifically so that we could make this space appropriate for a puppy. We have set up his bed, we've set up his crate, we've bought toys and food and everything, and now we just need the puppy. It feels like we've been waiting for this day for so long. We met him exactly 3 weeks ago today, and it just feels like we've been waiting forever to come and pick him up. We keep getting photo updates of him and his litter mates, and they're just so cute, and I can't wait to bring him home. Matt and I have wanted a dog for ages, but we wanted to make sure it was the right timing. We wanted to make sure we were in the new house, which had a big garden. So we're obviously settled in there. So we think that it's the right time now. And we started looking for a litter and we knew what breed we wanted. So when we found this litter that are only 45 minutes away, they were born at the beginning of November. It's just perfect. So I've spoken to the breeder, said I've finished work and that I'm home and I'm changed, and she said hop in the car and come and find us. So we're gonna leave now. It's about a 45 minute drive, so I'm so excited.
Good boy, come on then.
Breeder has had him on puppy kibble and lean beef mince.
Oh, okay.
So we're home now. Little one has just been exploring. We're just keeping him in the kitchen at the moment. He's had his dinner. The breeder's got him on a combination of kibble and raw beef mince, so we've had him on that. He's really good. He went to the toilet outside. He was a little bit sick on the drive home. I think it's partly to do with the country lanes around where we live, but I also think he was quite overexcited. He still is. I think he's gonna zonk out soon as well. He seems quite tired. But they're just outside in the garden now, playing again. And then we're trying to introduce him to his crate this evening so that he can sleep in it happily tonight. I think we're probably going to have quite a rough night ahead of us, but that's part of the deal.
Thank you.
It's been a couple of weeks now since we've had little Murphy. He is making himself at home really, really well. Our first night was absolutely fine. We did the first couple of nights with the crate in our bedroom, and he actually never needed to go out in the middle of the night. He settled, we put him to bed at like, I think it was about 10:30, 10:45, and then he was up at about 5:30, 5:45. So we didn't actually have to take him out at kind of midnight or anything like that, which was lovely. I think we've just been really lucky in that respect. And yeah, so we did the first couple of nights in our bedroom, then we moved the crate out onto the landing and did a couple of nights with him there, so that if he kind of got unsettled in the night, he could hear us and we could say, oh, it's okay. And again, he was sleeping really well through the night then. And then we moved the crate downstairs and he now sleeps in the kitchen where his crate was in the earlier clips that you've seen. And yeah, so he sleeps down there. He sleeps, we put him to bed about 10:30 and he now is getting to the point where he sleeps until about 6:30. And he has never, touch wood, he has never weed or pooed in his crate, which I'm so, so pleased about. The house training's going really, really well. We've been doing, we've got like a book. So every time he goes out and has a wee or does a number two, we write it down so we know the timings, and we're trying to get to know little patterns that he has. So from that, we've learned that after he has his lunch and after he has his dinner, he needs to go straight out, like within seconds. Because we've had a couple of accidents where he's had his lunch and has then got excited looking at something and has had an accident on the kitchen floor. And it's just because we didn't know that that's what he needs. So we're learning and we're getting to know his little patterns, which is lovely. So yeah, I think we're getting there with the house training now, which is just fantastic. Obviously he can't go for walks just yet, so we've been keeping him in the house, but we've been trying to keep him busy, doing little bits of training and things so he can do sit. We're trying to teach him to learn bed so that we can send him to his bed, and try and persuade him to go in there a little bit more. He actually really likes his crate, and he'll go in it quite voluntarily during the day, but then when we go to put him to bed at night, I think he knows that he's gonna be shut in there at night and we're not gonna be there. So he's developed a little thing where he tries to avoid going in there. So we're trying to do some training during the day where we give him a treat if he goes to his bed, and telling him to go to his bed and giving him a treat. So I think that's something that we're working on. But yeah, it's been really lovely. I wasn't very well the first couple of weeks that we had him home. I developed a really nasty sick bug. So I feel like I've missed out a little bit on being able to kind of play and things, just because I haven't been feeling well at all. But I am feeling much better now. But Matt's been amazing. Matt was getting up with him at 5:30 and kind of taking him out and things so that I could rest a bit, which has just been amazing. So yeah, he's been fab. He'll be able to go for a walk beginning of February. I think it's like the first week, a week into February, he can go for a walk. So we just need to wait for a second set of vaccines. But yeah, he's doing really, really well, and we are completely smitten. I will do another update video. I'm planning on filming little bits of footage as he grows up, so I will do an update as he grows. And I really hope you've enjoyed seeing him coming into our lives and the kind of run-up to bringing him home and getting him settled. I think you'll see quite a lot of him in future videos, obviously, because he's our baby. But yeah, I really hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please like and subscribe, and I will see you for the next one.